Welcome. Welcome. We are in the next presentation, and we have a special presenter today here. Today is Dirk Bockelmann from BD Rover here. Great to have you here, Dirk. Fantastic.
And thank you very much for the invitation.
And most people probably have never heard about BD Rover. In German, Rover is a bit more known, but BD Rover is it's probably for most of them because it's not a typical digital signage company. But we thought we want to hear and learn a little bit about, you know, what BD Rover does and what role digital signage plays, because it's very, very fascinating. BD Rover, they invented and they're rolling out automation for pharmacies. And but not only that, that's not only limited to, you know, distribution pharmaceuticals, but also obviously really to give pharmacists a full ecosystem of communication solutions. And that's something we would like to hear. So Dirk, over to you. You brought us a few slides, and give us please a short introduction about BD Rover, and then we will have a few questions.
Yeah, thank you very much for the invitation. As you said, as Florian said, my name is Dirk Bockelmann. I'm now 6 years with the company. Before I had some experience with NCR and Wincor Nixdorf, so always in the ATM and retail environment, a lot things to do with customer journeys. And I brought you and I prepared a slide presentation and would like to show you a couple of these ideas, what we are trying to market. First of all, this is one of our robots from the inside. This year we have installed, even in the Corona season, we installed robots. Now 10,000 was installed in Australia, and we are storing medication. And this is how this looks. You have the picking arm in the middle, and we are part of Becton Dickinson. Becton Dickinson is a global medical technology player. I'd like to now. The company was established in 1897 and was established around syringes. And right now we are a $60 billion company, 65,000 employees. And Rover is a platform of that international medtech company. A couple slides around BD Rover. Rover is the abbreviation for Rolf Wagner. Rolf founded the company in 1996, and in Germany, his father was in automotive, and they tried to build a second leg of the company to be more risk averse, and they decided to do something in the medical space, and we started obviously in Germany. We have more than 4,000 units installed. And we are all over continental Europe, as well as UK and Ireland, and in the Nordics. And we are quite present in Australia as well, and New Zealand. And the first machine in Tasmania was installed also last year. So we are now developing new areas, specifically China, which is a completely different market when it comes to medication. That's much more based on hospitals. And we are also going to Argentina, to Chile, to Brazil, and into the Americas, to North America and Canada. And the latest development, as we are starting with the Baltic countries and Eastern European countries. That's Dirk, where we are currently present.
Dirk, maybe before you continue, could you give us a short overview? Why do you need automation in a pharmacy, and how does the design of the pharmacy change once you have a robot? I mean, it's for you, but for the majority of the people, and we have probably 2,000 people watching, it's really, you know, to better understand, you know, what the main benefit is.
Yeah, it's all about, thank you. It's all about process optimization. So whenever you receive medication from a wholesaler, and usually you have more than 5,000 SKUs, so more than 5,000 articles in your pharmacy, and you need to control that inventory stock. And what our robot does, it's like a hard disk. It manages each item pack by pack, and the robot is aware of each expiry date. And that is something what is usually done by pharmacy staff, but worldwide we experience a lack of pharmacy staff. So less and less people decide to become a pharmacy technician or a pharmacist, and therefore we are filling this gap with automation, and this since more than 20 years.
And what does it mean for the pharmacy? For the pharmacy, it means more space in the sales floor, right? Because in the past they had all these shelves, and the whole ground floor was fitted with shelves for the medication. And now you can move it to the basement or to a different floor or so, because it's connected, and that means you have more space. You can create better experiences in a pharmacy.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. And we don't need. I mean, we can put that robot into a niche in the pharmacy. We don't need to have it accessible, like you need access to your drawers, to your physical drawing system. And we are usually much smaller than these physical drawers, that you can reduce the size of your back office and have more space for your front office. And as you said, we're even able to put this robot into the basement or the first floor, which frees up even much more space. And that's message of the automation, yeah.
Okay, cool. And the great thing is, as we talk about digital signage, this is a digital signage conference. Now we have freed up space in the pharmacy, because the shelves are in the basement or somewhere else. Now we can create new experiences. And one of the thing, and that's where you're a very specialist, and where you develop something which is far beyond your core product line, is having touch screens there, or more screens. So what are the benefits of having screens, and how can they support the pharmacy to better serve and sell more products?
Yeah, it's all about management of the stock, and we, using the robot, it creates a lot of free space. I mean, we are using that robot to transport pack by pack behind the counter. That means that the pharmacist or the pharmacy technician has more time for the consultation and for the patient, and does not have to walk away for every new pack. And that is supportive for more cross-selling. And cross-selling in a medical environment is about self-medication. So non-prescription medication, and we thought it's a benefit to have every indication, like pain, like flu relief, on your fingertip. And this is why we have chosen to use large format touch screens, that you don't have to walk away out of the conversation with your patient. And that was the main reason for that.
Yeah, cool, good. Let's continue a little bit. I think you brought a few more slides with it before we go into the other thing, because I would really like to talk a little bit about touch screens and all this stuff, but in content. Right. But you have a few more slides, yeah. So go ahead with that.
Yeah, we have. I mean, we are trying. So when I joined the company in 2014, it was more about the store and pick, which are the core products. I mean, all of our products, which are basically the robots. And what we did in the meantime is to work on this present and sell automation portfolio, which is vMotion and Self Checkout and Pickup and vShelf. And I brought this presentation here to show you a little bit about these items. Maybe I skip a couple of these slides. This one I would like to show you. This is what we consider the customer journey pharmacy. It starts on the sofa at home, where most of the Germans know pharmacy Apothekenumschau, which is a very well-known pharmacy magazine, and a lot of advertising in that for self-medication and also for cosmetics, pharmacy exclusive cosmetics. And we show this kind of customer journey to show where we put our product, and also to identify where is the product missing in that customer journey. This is why we also are in the shopping window. We have worked on pickup solutions, and we have worked also on the smart shelf solutions and as well as self-checkout, to have a seamless portfolio for a good customer journey.
And Dirk, it's really interesting when you talk about the smart shelf. The smart shelves, you're thinking about integrating sensors, right? So it can count, or it can measure how many products are there, so it can really enable the pharmacist to have a 100% status quo always of his products available and everything, so he can order in early enough or so. I think it's really about making the whole pharmacy smart, not only for the medications, but also for all the standard products in the pharmacy.
Right. I mean, we will see many more platforms in the future, nationwide pharmacy platforms. And obviously, we know exactly what is in the robot, but we don't know exactly what is on the shelves. So when you sell something or you reserve something, a click and reserve for a patient coming into your pharmacy or using one of these pickup solutions, you would like to make sure that you have that product on stock, the physical product, and not just maybe an item in your IT system. So it has to be there, and that is why we are using also these smart shelves in the free trade area, which is more or less cosmetics and nutrition. And this is our extension to have a 100% visibility of physical packs of that pharmacy.
Okay, cool. And talk a little bit about content, because you found out it's great. No, before we talk about content, first the displays. You talked about displays can really add value. So many pharmacies now start to introduce, you know, large format displays behind the counter. Many of them also touch. What can you do with touch? You can order products there, or you can change the content according to your target group? Oh, great, yeah.
Yeah, let me show you what we have put together. We call this under the umbrella of present and sell. So we started that journey in 2014, and we installed the first pharmacies, these screens, we call them V-Motion. These touch screens, we installed this in September in 2014 in Germany, down in Landsberg am Lech. And we used that because that pharmacist has a very low OTC, so self-medication, and he wanted to have the pharmacy very, very clean looking, and also this extended time of consultation. That is why we started with the touch screens, and you can see one picture of that in the middle. So there you can see from Mea Apotheke how this looks like. Each of these templates is one indication, so flu relief, pain relief, something like that. And it became over time, it became also a new item in store design, as you can see that on the left side. Now we are experiencing more into outside of the, so we started with the behind the counter, and now we are going to the public area, into the shopping area, and also into inside of the store on the shop floor.
And Dirk, when I visited you at the last big Expo Pharma, what the big show was called, was quite fascinating to see what you're offering. I mean, you're even doing the content now. So you're collecting all the photos, all the text, everything. So you have this whole ecosystem. And secondly, you also had a visual merchandiser there to really, you know, teach and train the pharmacist what to put on a screen in a shop window or so. You really identified There's a big need. You can just not only sell screens, but you really need to help them 360 degrees, right?
Yeah. When we started, everybody has that dream that you are selling this large format touchscreens and somebody is putting software on it. I think that we are this somebody putting software on it, and it's, in average, it's 4.3 touch screens per pharmacy, and we have now more than 1,300 equipped since 2014. It is still an adjacent product to our robot, but it makes the combination is quite nice, because when you touch on one of these products, the robot spits it out. And this is everything I show you right now on that slide that is behind the counter, because in most of the countries, it needs to be handed over by a pharmaceutical staff. So you cannot just let the customers play with that. So this is an product which is managed by the pharmacy staff. And we found out that they are not very good in preparing content. So we are doing this for them. We are now in more than 19 countries with that product, even in Japan. And we are scanning packs in each and every country. So we are having our own database of pack shots, but also we provide advertising in combination with the pharmaceutical industry, country by country. That's very country-based.
Fantastic. Dirk, unfortunately, we're running a little bit out of time, but we will share this presentation with all our delegates. And obviously, if they have questions, your address and everything is there. It's really, really fascinating. And thanks for being here today, because we thought it's something new, it's something different, and it's quite innovative, and it's a holistic approach. So thanks for being here, and I hope to see you soon. Thank you, Dirk.